Craft Holsters is a company that specializes in top quality, custom made leather holsters for your handgun. They make holsters for a wide variety of handguns and they offer a vast array of holster styles to suit your carry needs. Today I'm specifically going to be talking about the model OK1 shoulder holster and the model T1 thumb break holster. So what is my relationship to Craft Holsters? Full disclosure, Craft Holsters did send me 4 of the 5 holsters I have here for this review. Because this is my channel and because I never allow companies to pay me for my reviews, I have the freedom of saying whatever I want in my videos. Craft Holsters is just a company I'm very fond of, and I feel like they don't get nearly the amount of publicity and recognition that they deserve. Craft Holsters has encouraged me to only speak the truth regardless of my experiences with them. So, as always, I'll be doing just that. I have a lot to cover today, so let's get right into it. When examining a holster from Craft Holsters, it's not hard to see that the quality of the craftsmanship is excellent and their eye for detail is immaculate. All of the holsters I have here are made from the finest Italian leather with a gorgeous mahogany finish. My preference is the mahogany leather, but they also offer a black finish if your style requires a change in scenery. The stitching is very strong, made with German thread, and those of you out there who are men and women of culture know without a shadow of a doubt that the stitching is robust and will hold up, because... Craft Holsters' variety regarding the guns they support is amazing. They make holsters for pretty much everything that's mainstream, but they even offer a lot of support for out-of-production or niche pistols that might be a bit harder to find holsters for. You'd think the CZ-75, being the second most widely used handgun in the world, would be easy to find good quality holsters for. Think again. I had the worst time trying to find a holster for my CZ-75, but when I discovered Craft Holsters, I found all I could ever need. More on that later. Growing up on shows like Miami Vice and X-Files, you see a lot of cool cats carrying their guns in a lot of cool styles. Perhaps the ultimate cool guy carry style would be the shoulder holster. More specifically, the Sonny Crockett style. The model OK1 holster orients your pistol horizontally on your weak side and allows you to carry 2 spare magazines on your strong side, for the timelessly classy under-the-jacket cross-draw style. For a night out on the town, this kind of holster is a must. Those of you who carry a gun daily know that appendix carry, and especially IWB strong side carry, can sometimes be rather difficult to draw from while in a seated position. They can also be very uncomfortable when sitting or driving for extended periods of time. Enter the shoulder holster. I am a huge fan of Miami Vice and how much cooler Don Johnson made shoulder holsters look. And of course, you can't forget about Bruce Willis and Die Hard, which is a Christmas movie. One of my all-time favorite things to do is drive around downtown at night with my best friend. He and I always love to get dinner at one of the little mom-and-pop Vietnamese restaurants on the boulevard. before spending a couple of hours driving around town, laughing, and listening to music. It's become a tradition of ours, and nearly every time we go, I carry in one of my OK1 shoulder holsters. Not only does it make me feel like I'm the protagonist of an 80s detective show, but it's also immensely more comfortable than other methods of carry, and it allows me to pack 2 spare magazines. The city is a completely different world at night, and as interesting and fun as it can be, it can also be very dangerous. You've got to be prepared for anything, especially nowadays, and with craft holsters, I can enjoy the wonders of the place I live with full confidence that I have enough firepower to handle any situation. Every time I smell the gentlemanly mahogany finish of a leather holster, it reminds me of funky retro city pop, neon lights, and midnight pho on the boulevard with my homie. So if that doesn't make you want a shoulder holster, I don't know what will. The time I spend with him getting to catch up and just enjoy life is absolutely blissful. And I'd be lying if I said that rocking a stainless steel pistol and an OK1 shoulder holster weren't a substantial part of that. And for the 80s detective open carry style, look no further than the Model T1 thumbbrake holster. Back in the day, Special Agent Fox Mulder carried in this style. And let's face it, if you're open carrying, you probably should too. Traditional thumbbrake holsters are generally much safer than something like a Black Hawk Serpa. Adequate retention is provided, and your booger hook still stays far away from the trigger guard so that you don't accidentally end up doing this.
I just f***ing
shot myself!
Oh, son of a bitch!
A lot of the time, when you order a leather holster from a company, it's one that's been mass-produced as part of a batch, to be immediately shipped out. But with craft holsters, each holster is truly custom and handled with care. Craft holsters doesn't make it until after you've ordered it. They say that every holster has a story. Well, that's absolutely the truth. As a lot of you who have kept up with me for a long time know, I'm an Eagle Scout. This CZ-75 matte stainless was a gift from my dad, which he presented to me at my Eagle ceremony. Because of how special this pistol is to me, it needed a truly special holster. So I reached out to craft holsters when having this one made, and had it monogrammed with my initials. A one-of-a-kind holster for a one-of-a-kind gun. More recent embossings will feature a stunning gold inlay that will make your monogram pop. For those looking for the ultimate exercise in ostentatiousness, Craft Holsters also has a custom shop. Their offerings from the custom shop are a bit more expensive than my bank account would like to admit, but when it comes to Craft Holsters, it goes without saying that you'll be getting what you pay for. As awesome as leather holsters are, they sometimes require a bit of maintenance, and they can also sometimes require a bit of breaking in. Fortunately, I haven't had either of these issues with my holsters. And doubly fortunately, Craft Holsters also offers maintenance and break-in kits for your holster. I am of the opinion that every gentleman should have a shoeshine kit, for kicks and holsters alike.
Pardon me, boy. Is this the Transylvania station?
Yeah, track 29! Oh, can I give you a shine?
No thanks.
But if you've spent all this time neglecting the single most important item in a mad scientist kit, Craft Holsters can get you hooked up. And if Craft Holsters doesn't have exactly what you're looking for in their own product lineup, they also stock a variety of holsters from Falco. Like this IWB holster for the CZ-75. Kydex holsters are awesome for retaining rigidity, and honestly, they're probably the best option out there for something inherently more risky like appendix carry. But for open carry, or the ultimate display of classiness, leather holsters are where it's at. Overall, my experience with craft holsters has been 100% positive. However, I have had an issue which they encouraged me to talk about so that they can potentially improve the quality of their products. As I've covered on this channel in the fairly recent past, I don't judge a company based on how they handle things when they're going great, I judge them based on how they handle things when they're going wrong. Many companies believe that they are always right and that you're an audacious buffoon if you dare to critique how they do things. But Craft Holsters is the exact opposite of that. They have a dedicated and attentive support staff willing to listen to any issues you may have. As aforementioned, I enjoy the ability to speak freely on my channel due to the fact that I have no contractual obligations and no accountability to censor what I say based on a company's bribery. Thus, everything I say is and always will be 100% honest and from the heart. And because of Craft Holsters' transparency as a company, they have encouraged me to speak the truth regardless of my experience with them. When I initially received my T1 holster a couple of years ago, I did encounter an issue with it. As you can see here, there was once a bit of leather that covered my gun's magazine release. This bit of leather would depress the magazine release and actually caused the magazine to eject while my gun was in the holster. It would eject anytime I walked, ran, or even shifted the angle of the grip slightly. Obviously, that's not good. So I took my holster to a local leatherwork shop and had it modified. The craftsmen at Craft Holsters were so apologetic about this issue that they actually sent me a holster of my choosing for free. I can't speak for T1 holsters made for other gun makes and models, only the two I have here. But the example I have for my CZ-75 featured the magazine release coverage, as does the holster for my Smith & Wesson 5906. This likely isn't a problem with a lot of other gun designs, but obviously in-holster magazine ejection is a cause for concern. There's really no need for a gun's magazine release to be covered while in the holster. So my recommendation to craft holsters would be for future renditions of their holsters to completely omit magazine release coverage. Knowing the kind of company Craft Holsters is, I'm absolutely certain they're soon to be redesigning the T1 holster to resolve this issue. I have noticed that the T1 holster I have for my 5906 features magazine release coverage as well, but the magazine release is so much smaller than that of the CZ-75 that I don't foresee it being an issue. It's important to note that the leather used to make my newer T1 is noticeably thicker and more rigid than the original. Thus, I have to be deliberately trying to eject the magazine to do so. I'd really love to get a new, updated T1 for my CZ-75 when the redesign is complete because of how thin the leather is on my original.
My holster
has lost its integrity.
Something that's just a judicious OCD-based recommendation of mine would be to utilize retention straps that are a little bit more stiff when manufacturing shoulder holsters, or maybe do something to potentially increase the stiffness of the snaps already used. When talking about vertically oriented holsters, retention snaps aren't nearly as much of an issue, but for a horizontally oriented holster, gravity is a far greater factor of consideration that just might be waiting to bite you. Nobody wants to have their gun fall out of the holster and get scuffed up. It's embarrassing and even potentially dangerous, and in some jurisdictions, your gun falling out of the holster in public could mean jail time or even prison, especially if you negligently discharge it into the leg of a bar patron. So even if the retention snaps are a little bit more stiff than some people might prefer, it's better to have a secure holster than to have to explain to Bubbles why you need to borrow his soap. Another recommendation of mine would be to take greater advantage of the market for custom holsters by further expanding on the range offered for niche, out-of-production guns.
For example, I really need a shoulder holster for this bad girl. But given that she hasn't seen production in nearly 25 years, that isn't easy. And that in mind, the current offerings on the market, shoulder holsters especially, leave a lot to be desired. To the guys at Craft Holsters, I would absolutely love to see you guys start producing holsters for guns like the Smith & Wesson 1006. I'm just dying to get an OK-1 shoulder holster for mine. Heck, I'll even track down a pistol mold for you guys if you can promise me a holster for it. I realize that the problem with the niche market is just that. But like I said, I think there's a lot of potential for holster companies to take requests regarding obscure, out-of-production pistols. I'm sure there's a lot more that goes into it logistically speaking, like tracking down the pistol mold, and the obvious business consideration of supply and demand. In the age of Kydex holsters and futuristic polymer handguns, it's truly refreshing to see a company like Craft Holsters who makes it so that Gen Z kids like myself can still enjoy the fine craftsmanship of a leather holster. Unfortunately, I never got to experience the 80s, and unless they start making DeLoreans with flux capacitors, I never will. Really not holding my breath on that one. But thanks to companies like Craft Holsters, we still get to enjoy the chic styles of the 80s in more ways than our clothes, cars, and music. So if you're looking for that taste of the 20th century that you're too young to have experienced, or if you just want to relive it, go check out Craft Holsters. Also, I'd like to give a special thanks to my buddy Al over at Craft Holsters for making this collaboration possible. Buddy, I love your name, but every time we talk, I get Paul Simon stuck in my head. That having been said, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please press like and subscribe to keep up with my channel. It really helps. As always, thank you so much for watching. Stay safe and have a very Merry Christmas.
If anyone out there happens to be selling a stainless steel hammer and trigger for the Smith & Wesson 5906 that happens to look like this one here on the Smith & Wesson 1006, please let me know. I will gladly take them off your hands.
I don't consider drunk driving to be a felony.
This video is brought to you by heart failure.
Brought to you by cholesterol.
By clogged arteries.
If you're hooked up to a heart monitor like me, this video is perfect
please,
for you.
Please press like and subscribe if you're hooked up to a heart monitor
if
before
you,
the age of 40.
If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with cardiopulmonary embolisms or mesothelioma before the age of 40, you may be entitled.
You may be entitled to financial compensation.
If you or a loved one experience these symptoms to these unknown diseases that nobody's ever heard of, you may be entitled to money.
Literally, I've never heard of anybody having
money. I like his
I do too. I like that a lot.
I kind of want that.
You should get one that has like, it's just a giant cock that just points in a certain direction, but it glows and pulsates.
Dave.
Stop.
No, I have a question.
No,
I have a question.
You're not posting.
Look me in the eyes.
No.
Look me in the eye.
Which one? The camera eye or
my
you?
Eyes. My eyes.
Yes.
I told you not to squeeze my
God damn it.
Also, believe it or not, I'm not sponsored to show off my beautiful, beautiful shirt. Yeah, I'm into science. What can I say? My future's so bright, I gotta wear shades.
But I'm probably gonna need to take a shower when we get home since I just realized I was laying in a big mound of cow
shit. That's alright.
Builds character.
Don't step on me, pistol.
Come here, stinker. Aww. See, I told you guys she loves me. She's not terrified by me. Carl, would you please get out of the frame?
He goes, the f*** you.
I love you, Carl.